So we are here to talk about our final project on data mining, that was building a recommendation system using Yelp dataset. So my name is Abhay Kasturia. I'll just go about a bit of the introduction of what we did. So just as an outline for today's presentation, we'll just go briefly over what are recommendation systems, what was the pre-processing that we did on Yelp dataset, what methods we applied, and how was the method evaluated and the results. So what are recommendation systems and why they became popular? So recommendation system is nothing but based on user activity on a particular website or on a particular product, you try to recommend similar items to that user. So this started with when the internet boom came in, where Amazon was recommending books to users, and Last.fm was recommending music to users based on a similar taste.
Okay, so hi everybody, my name is Aditya. I'll go about this basic project goal is building a recommendation system here. And you can look at the data set, which has around 4 million reviews and 150,000 businesses across 12 metropolitan cities. We are not using the pictures here in this case. And so we did some basic data analysis to see how the rating is distributed and, you know, the average number of reviews given by a user, which shows the two problems of sparsity and lack of negative reviews. And this shows the user growth and the distribution of different categories in a city of Las Vegas. And so the basic pre-processing is we filter the businesses which are restaurants and took only users which have more than 20 reviews. And we converted the IDs, string IDs, to integer, and we divided the data into training and test set based on the timeline. Basically, anything till 2015 was training, and beyond that is testing data. And these are the methods which we'll talk about, is basically clustering, collaborative filtering, and deep learning approach.
Hello everyone, my name is Xinxin. So in the clustering approach, we have several assumptions. We assume that the users and the business we use are from the same location, and we try to limit the business type into just the restaurant only. So for each of the user and business, we build a preference vector of the top 15 categories based on user's review. If the user doesn't have a review on that particular business, we assign a neutral value to that category. And for the business, we only take the business that has at least contain at least three of the top 15 categories. And after that, we did an agglomerative hierarchical clustering to the users. Okay, so what we did in the clustering is basically compute proximity metrics of the user based on the user's vector. And because we took out 15 categories, so we think it's reasonable to divide the user into 15 clusters.
Hello, my name is Varun, and I'm going to explain the further process in clustering. So after we do clustering of users, we build an average preference vector of the cluster of user. After we build the average preference vector, we take that average preference vector and calculate the dot product with each business vector that we created earlier. So if the dot product is higher, that means it's more similar. So we recommend that business at the top of the list. In this way, we get like top 20 businesses for the average preference vector. In clustering results, we use two approaches, hit ratio and NDCG, that is normalized discounted cumulative gain. Hit ratio basically tells us that if a user has been to a business, if he liked the business or he didn't like the business, and NDCG just tells us that how well he liked the business. And these are our results.
Hi, I'm Gautam Vashisht, and I'm here to explain the user-based collaborative filtering. We have used the collaborative filtering using the similarity between the users, and we have built the utility metrics between user and items. And the thing is that we face the issue of having these hard users and the soft users, the users which gives different amount of ratings. So it's not fair to compare these results. So that's why we have used the centralized mean approach to update the data of our utility metrics. So the value of zero represents the neutral rating, and above zero represents positive rating given by the user, and below zero represents the negative rating given by the user. So that's the rating prediction formula which we have used, summation of this similarity between the users of, and we have selected the top k users to find the similarity. In our particular experiment, we have given the 10 users only, but we can increment that number of users to above level to have more accuracy. And we predicted the particular rating, average rating for the business, the user which the user will give to the business which he hasn't visited yet. And somehow this user based filtering this model doesn't perform well as its mean square, as when we have tested it on test data, its mean square error came to a very large value. It might be because of the number of similar users which we have used very less, which is equal to 10, or might be because we have somehow mishandled the centralized mean approach. So definitely after this we will work on that. Thank you.
Hi guys, this is Abhay again. So I'll talk about, can you go to the next slide? So I'll talk about collaborative filtering using matrix factorization. So the technique that we used for matrix factorization was called ALS, that is called alternative least squares. So we have a problem in which we have to predict the rating of a particular user for a particular business. So we do it by taking the transpose of the Q matrix, Q vector, and taking the dot product with the P vector, where Q vector is the vector of all the businesses and P vector is the vector of all the users. So how do we predict using this equation is that we come up with this function that we have to optimize, in which this is the actual rating of the user for that product and this is our predicted rating. And taking the square of the sum gives us the MSC, and we use a regularization factor of lambda multiplied with the values for the vectors. So in order to solve this quadratic equation, we can do this using ALS. How does ALS work for this is that keeping one of the two unknowns as a random value and then trying to optimize the other one. So it keeps on alternating between optimizing P and optimizing Q. That's where it gets its name from, called alternative least squares. So this ensures that in each of the iterations, the cost function is minimized, so it will finally reach converge. So yet again, so the parameters that we used for ALS was the regularization parameter lambda, the max iterations that we have to cover, and the max rank value, that is the number of latent factors. So the values that we kept for our model was 0.15, max iteration was 20, and the rank was 100. And these parameters was kept keeping in mind the complexity of the algorithm that it will take. So that's why we have to restrict the number of latent vectors to at a max of 100. So these were the outputs that we got. We can see that for the non-regularized model, we got a testing MSC of 2.2, which is very high. So we regularized it, that brought it down to 1.4. This shows us that we were overfitting our data when we were not regularizing. And the final hit ratio for regularized model was 0.77 for us.
Hi everyone. So I'll talk about a deep learning approach. There are two important things here. The first thing is we try to formulate a collaborative filtering using the multilayer perceptrons. And the other important thing here is we use implicit feedback, which basically means, one, if a user has given a review to a business, and zero otherwise. And this is the deep neural architecture of the network. So you can see here we use one hot vectors for both user and item. We combine it and use it as an embedding layer. The different layers, which are multilayer perceptron, basically dense layer where everything is connected to everything, with ReLU activation functions. And the final output is just a zero, between 0 and 1, which uses a softmax activation function. And we use point-wise loss to train the model here. And so we use four hidden layers with these factors, and similar to other techniques, which we use hit ratio and NDCG to measure the quality. And you can see the results here. And so overall, if you look at the techniques to compare both explicit and implicit, so among all this, DNN performs the best out of all these. And so finally, till now we have used only the reviews and the user IDs and item IDs. And in future, we can use the texture data and image-based data to do our calculation. And also, we can use hybrid recommendation system, which are kind of the state of art, where you try to use all the information you have about the user and the item. Thank you.